for the first time in the 40-year history of the FISA court, the application for a warrant to surveil a subject was released through a FOIA request. And this was the warrant obtained under the FISA Act, essentially Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act, against Carter Page as a suspected Russian asset and now former Trump advisor. And, you know, we've had plenty of times where there have been things that have been subjected to different spin and maybe different interpretation. But what's going on with this you wrote about is sort of amazing.
Well, it is. I mean, you know, first of all, I mean, this is very, this, well, as you point out, it's totally unprecedented that they would have released this information under a Freedom of Information Act. I mean, this is a, these are secret warrants in a secret court, and the whole point of it is to, you know, allow the intelligence community and the investigators to be able to do all this on the QT. There are a million problems with the process. I mean, we've been down this road for the last 15 years, you know, with it's about surveilling American citizens, and there are a lot of reasons why people are legitimately suspicious of a process like this that's in secret. Having said that, there are actual threats to the United States, and there are actual reasons why you want the intelligence community to do these sorts of things if it's absolutely necessary and it follows some kind of a process that is, you know, protects the rights of American citizens. So this, you know, to just sort of do this thing where they just went in and forced to release this all stems from the fact that Donald Trump, the President of the United States, unilaterally declassified the Nunes memo, which you'll recall, and everybody I'm sure remembers that whole saga, was a product of the House Intelligence Committee, the Republicans on the House Intelligence Committee, who claimed that the FBI had erroneously gotten permission to surveil Carter Page, who was at the time a who had been an advisor to the Trump campaign, and that they had received it using bogus information that came from the Steele dossier, the famous dossier that was, you know, that was passed around before the election. And because that had been financed partially by the Clinton campaign, this was then sort of portrayed as being some kind of a partisan hit job, which the FBI eagerly jumped on and used to surveil this guy, Carter Page. Well,
and we should also say that in their present, I mean, as far as we were told by the Nunes memo, the FBI made no reference to who, where this information actually came from, you know, because of course, if it's, you know, if it's Oppo research, there should be at least, you know, you should know that if it's part. And so there was, according to the Nunes memo, the FBI hid that information.
Right.
From. Right. Go ahead.
Right. So they hid it allegedly. And, you know, and at the time, the Democrats put out a companion memo, which said, no, they didn't hide it. They actually, it's there. And the judges, and by the way, four successive judges, all of whom were appointed by Republicans, signed these warrants, allowing this surveillance to continue. And so, but we didn't know what happened. Now, because Donald Trump declassified all this, unilaterally did that, as which is within his purview as a president, unprecedented for a president to declassify this, and it's purely for political reasons. But by declassifying the Nunes memo, which he thought was a clever thing to do because they could put out this sort of phony narrative and the Democrats would put out a competing one and no one would know what was the truth, and you could sort of pick and choose what you wanted to believe. But in doing so, what he ended up doing was declassifying the warrant applications altogether. And so the FOIA request, which had been put through by a number of different people, some on the right and some on the left, were finally released over the weekend. And what they showed, unsurprisingly, was exactly what the Democrats had said in their competing memo. The Republicans were completely wrong. The FBI had not relied solely on the Steele dossier. They had relied, they had a mountain of other evidence and a whole bunch that's redacted that we don't even know. But what we do know shows that there was much more to their suspicions, including the fact that they had been looking at Carter Page for years. He had been on their radar as a potential Russian asset. So, you know, when he showed up in a presidential campaign, it naturally perked up their interest a little bit. Furthermore, they didn't start the surveillance process till after he left the Trump campaign. So any idea that this was some kind of a sabotage of the Trump campaign would make no sense since he left afterwards. Moreover, all the information that about the Steele dossier and all of that was, as the Democrats had said, it was in the warrant application. So at the end of the day, basically this proved what the Democrats had said, that this was a legitimate warrant application. In other words, the FBI was right to be suspicious. Now, whether or not anything was proven about Carter Page or anything will be proven, we don't know that. But we do know that they had an absolute good reason to be suspicious and to follow up on this. This was a presidential campaign with a guy they'd been following for years as a potential Russian agent. So, of course, they were going to look into it and follow him around and see what he was doing. And here's the part that is really stunning. All of that, you would think that's the end of the story, right? I mean, we now know what happened. Nunes, you know, would have to hang his head in shame or basically just disappear into the ether. They change the subject or whatever. Instead, the right, and seemingly in a coordinated effort, have decided to simply deny what is in black and white, what the facts are, what we can all see. I read the documents. Millions of other people have read them. Certainly all the people who are educated about these sorts of things have read them, and everybody can see what the truth is, and the right's saying no. You can believe me, or you can believe your lying eyes. And what I'm telling you is that everything Nunes said is true. And even if people sit there and read out parts of the warrant application and say, no, it says this, they will look people right in the eye and say, no, that's not actually true. That's not happening. It's the strangest thing I've ever seen, because usually you see spin, you see, you know, some kind of, you know, PR attempt at damage control, finding some way to make this look okay. They're not even trying. They're just denying reality. And it's really disconcerting to see them do that. It took until, I think it was on Tuesday, after days of this and pundits and op-ed columnists saying this, Richard Burr, the head of the Senate Select Intelligence Committee, who has been looking into these same things, of course, and he's a Republican from North Carolina. Right. They caught him in the hallway, and he said, no, he says, I'm appalled that these warrant applications were actually made public or had to be made public, but they obviously prove that the FBI had good reason to surveil Carter Page. And I kind of did a sigh of relief. I'm going, all right, well, at least it isn't an across-the-board, you know, total epistemological, you know, explosion here where right. people are actually across the board going to deny reality. And he sort of put, I think he may have been one who has now put a bit of a damper on that particular strategy. But it was astonishing. I mean, I couldn't believe what I was seeing.
Well, all right, Heather, let's take a break here, because we're seeing more of this strategy. I mean, Donald Trump later this week almost quoted you and said, like, don't listen to what you hear or what you see. They're lying to you. And it raises an important point in terms of impeachment, that it is a political process and not a criminal one. We will expand on that in just a moment. We got to take a quick break. I'm Sam Seder. This is Ring of Fire Radio. Be right back with Heather Parton.